identical words in English and French, and we'll especially focus on the words in English that will end with E-O-N. Okay, keep in mind that the first thing that you should remember is that it must exist in French, because all these E-O-N words in English won't exist in French. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases the writing will change a little bit. Let's start. Mobilisation, modération, modernisation, modification, motivation, munition, mutation, mystification, narration, natation, nation, nationalisation, naturalisation, navigation, négation, nomination, notion, objection, obligation, observation, occasion, opération, opinion, opposition, optimisation, option, orchestration, organisation, orientation, pacification, palpitation, partition, passion, pension, perception, percussion, perfection, perforation, perfusion, permission, persécution, persuasion, perturbation, pétition, plantation, pollution, population, portion, position, possession. Identical words in English and French, and especially the words that will end with E-O-N. Keep in mind that not all the words in English that will end with E-O-N exist in French, so it must exist in French, of course, to be used in this language. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases the writing will change a little bit. Okay, so let's continue. Potion, précaution, précipitation, précision, prédiction, préméditation, prémonition, préoccupation, préparation, préposition, présentation, prévention, prévision, privatisation, procuration, production, profession, profusion, prohibition, projection, prolongation, promotion, proportion, proposition, propulsion, protection, protestation, provision, provocation, publication, pulsion, pulvérisation, punition, purification, qualification, ration, rationalisation, réaction, réactivation, réalisation, réclamation, récupération, rédaction, redécoration, redéfinition, rédemption, redirection, réduction, réévaluation, reformation. Identical words in English and French, and we were talking about the words in English that will end with E-O-N, okay? And that will be the same, but if they exist in French, because all the English words ending with E-O-N, well, they don't all exist in French. So that's the first thing that you should keep in mind. And then the second thing is that in some cases, we will write in French these words a little bit differently. So few cases like here, E would become E, and then Z would become S, okay? So let's continue. Région, régression, relation, relaxation, religion, rénovation, réorientation, réparation, répartition, répétition, reproduction, répulsion, réputation, résolution, respiration, restitution, restauration, restriction, réunification, réunion, révélation, révision, révolution, rotation, salutation, sanction, saturation, sécession, section, séduction, sélection, sensation, séparation, signalisation, signification, simulation, situation, spécialisation, spécification, spéculation, stabilisation, station, stimulation, soumission, succession, suffocation, suggestion, supervision, suppression, synchronisation, télévision, tension, torsion, traction, tradition, transaction, transcription, transformation, transition, transpiration, transportation, union, urbanisation, utilisation, vaccination, valorisation, vaporisation, variation, végétation, version, vibration, victimisation, violation, vision, vocation. Le corps humain, donc le vocabulaire concernant le corps humain. Le tube digestif. Le tube digestif. L'articulation. L'articulation. La bouche. La bouche. Le bras. Le bras. La cage thoracique. La cage thoracique. Le cerveau. Le cerveau. Les cheveux. Les cheveux. La cheville. La cheville. La clavicule. La clavicule. Le cœur. Le cœur. La colonne cervicale. La colonne cervicale. La colonne dorsale. La colonne dorsale. La colonne vertébrale. La colonne vertébrale. La côte. La côte. Le cou. Le cou. Le coude. Le coude. Le crâne. Le crâne. La cuisse. La cuisse. La dent. La dent. Le doigt. Le doigt. Le dos. Le dos. L'épaule. L'épaule. L'estomac. L'estomac. Le foie. Le foie. Le front. Le front. Le genou. Le genou. L'intestin. L'intestin. La jambe. La jambe. La joue. La joue. La lèvre. La lèvre. La mâchoire. La mâchoire. La main. La main. Le membre. Le membre. Le menton. Le menton. Le muscle. Le muscle. Le nerf. Le nerf. Le nez. Le nez. La nuque. La nuque. L'œil. L'œil. L'ongle. L'ongle. L'oreille. L'oreille. L'orteil. L'orteil. L'os. L'os. La paume de la main. La paume de la main. La phalange. La phalange. Le pied. Le pied. La plante du pied. La plante du pied. Le poignet. Le poignet. Le poing. Le poing. Le pouce. Le pouce. Le pouls. Le pouls. Le poumon. Le poumon. Le rein. Le rein. Le sang. Le sang. Le talon. Le talon. La tempe. La tempe. La tête. La tête. Le thorax. Le thorax. Le tibia. Le tibia. Oops, I made a mistake here. It should be masculine. Sorry about that. Le ventre. Le ventre. Les abrégements de mots. And we'll only focus in this video on les abrégements de mots, but well, the words that will end with O or the sound of O. Okay? So let's start now. Un adolescent. Un adolescent. Un adolescent. Okay, and then in most of the cases when people will speak, they will use un ado, un ado. Okay, so un adolescent will become un ado. Un apéritif will become un apéro. Un apéro. Okay, so un apéritif, un apéro. Une décoration, and it will become une déco. Okay, so une décoration, une déco. Une démonstration will become une démo. Une démonstration, une démo. Un dictionnaire will become un dico. Okay? Un dico. So one more time, un dictionnaire, un dico. Une exposition will become une expo. Une expo. Un hebdomadaire, so in that case we're talking about the magazine. Un hebdomadaire will become un hebdo. Okay? Un hebdo. So one more time. Un hebdomadaire, un hebdo. Un intellectuel will become un intello. Un intello. Okay, one more time. Un intellectuel. Un intello. Un laboratoire will become un labo. Un labo. Personnel will become perso. Perso. Okay, one more time. Personnel. Perso. Un professionnel will become un pro. Un pro. Okay, so un professionnel, un pro. Un propriétaire will become un proprio. Un proprio. Okay, so un propriétaire. Un proprio. Un restaurant will become un resto. Okay, so you can see that here you've got another way of writing it. Okay, but then, well, phonetically it's exactly the same. So un resto. Okay, so whether with O or then with AU, but then it's resto. Resto. The same way. Okay, so un restaurant. Un resto. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 12, Leçon C. And in this lesson, we will see les préfixes de verbes. So remember these little letters that you can put at the beginning of existing words, or in that case, it will be verbs. And by adding these little letters, you will modify the original meaning of the word. And in this lesson, we'll work on le préfixe de. Okay, and you'll see because, well, quite often I've been having some students that asked me, how do you translate in French, or is there a way to make this un that exists in English? So like do, undo, okay? And then the answer is yes. Actually, we've got this prefix de, okay? So it will actually be, well, the same. I mean, the use will be the same as in English, this un, or as well, there is this for some verbs. So it will be exactly the same thing, okay? We've got this de, okay? Keep in mind that we will see in the next lesson, so it will be unit 12, lesson D. We've got the option of D, accent aigu, S, and we will see that so in the next lesson, but in this lesson we'll only focus on the D. Okay, so let's take an example now. We've got branché, okay, and then débranché. All right, so it's actually quite easy. You just put this D in front of the verb and then branché. Branché, débranché. Centraliser, décentraliser. Okay, centraliser, and then it will become décentraliser. Charger, décharger. Okay, so charger and then décharger. Coiffer, décoiffer. All right, so coiffer, and then you put this D and after the verb décoiffer. Coller, décoller. Okay, so coller, and then it will become décoller. Commander will become décommander. Okay, so commander will become décommander. Composer, décomposer. All right, so composer will become décomposer. Conseiller will become déconseiller. All right, so conseiller, déconseiller. Couvrir will become découvrir. Okay, so couvrir, découvrir. Faire will become défaire. Okay, so faire, défaire. Former, déformer. All right, so former, déformer. Placer will become déplacer. Placer, déplacer. Plaire, déplaire. Plaire will become déplaire. Ranger, déranger. Okay, so ranger, déranger. And that's it. So keep in mind that, of course, it doesn't apply to all the verbs because in some cases it's not possible to modify the original verbs, okay? But then, well, this is quite useful because, as you can see, it's not that difficult, and then you could use these verbs quite often, okay? If you want more videos, then youtube.com/imagier, and then like me on Facebook, facebook.com/imagier.net, and you can find a lot of things at the following address, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Préfixe de verbe, and we'll focus this video on this préfixe D, accent aigu S. Okay, so actually, I've been having many questions regarding, or from students regarding the translation of this un préfix in English. So, like when you get do and undo, or this. Because it could be this as well for some verbs. And we saw in the previous lesson that the first prefix that we should use is D. Okay, it was in the lesson, so Unit 12, Lesson C. Okay, but then this prefix will be used for the verbs that will start with a consonant. Okay, but then we've got also verbs starting with a vowel, or then the mute H plus a vowel, and then in that case we'll have to use D, accent aigu S. Okay, so in this video we'll see this D, accent aigu S. Okay, and it will be used for, so the verb starting with a vowel, or then H, so H But then muet, mute, okay, plus a vowel. So remember that we're not talking about all the verbs starting with H. And then we will have also the option of DES, so you can see that you don't have any accent here, and it will be used only for the verbs that will start with the letter S here, okay? So keep in mind, DE accent aigu S will be used for verbs starting with whether une voyelle or H muet, okay? And then DE without the accent S will be used for the verbs starting with S. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one, s'abonner. S'abonner. Se désabonner. S'abonner. Se désabonner. Armer. Armer. Désarmer. Désarmer. Okay, so armer will give you this désarmer. Avantager. Avantager will give you désavantager. Désavantager. Équilibrer. Équilibrer will give you déséquilibrer. Déséquilibrer. Okay. Déquilibré, sorry, déséquilibré. Espérer, espérer, désespérer, désespérer. Ok, espérer, désespérer. Habiller, habiller, déshabiller, déshabiller. Ok, so you can see that here, this H here, this letter is not pronounced, so habiller and then déshabiller. Intéressé, intéressé, désintéressé, désintéressé. Obéir, obéir, désobéir, désobéir. Organiser, organiser, désorganiser, désorganiser. We'll start a series of videos that will cover the subject, les préfixes et les verbes. And this, in this video, we will see actually the verb dire. You get the translation here in English, so dire, okay? And then we'll see that it's possible to add some prefixes, so it's possible to add some letters before this dire, and then by adding these letters, we will modify the meaning of dire, okay? So let's see. And the first thing that we've got here is contre, and then dire, okay? Contredire. Contredire, and you can see that, of course, the meaning is changing. Contredire, okay? Then, interdire, interdire. Prédire, prédire. Redire, redire. Les préfixes et les verbes. So this video will only focus on the verb mener. Okay, this is the meaning of mener. Okay, and we'll see that by adding few letters in front of mener, we will actually change the meaning of this verb. So the original meaning of this verb, and this is right here the original meaning. Okay, so let's see now. The first one is amener. Amener. Okay, and you can see here the translation. Then, emmener, emmener, okay, same thing here. Ramener, ramener. Surmener, surmener. And then you've got the translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in this video we'll see the verb lever. Okay, so this is the translation in English of lever, and then we'll see that by adding few letters in front of lever will actually change the meaning of this verb. Okay, so, and the first one would be enlever, enlever, relever, relever, soulever, soulever. Les préfixes et les verbes, and we'll see in this video the verb mettre. Okay, so that's the translation of mettre. Okay, mettre. And so we'll see that when we add few letters in front of mettre, well, in this case, actually, it will change the meaning, the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so the first one will be admettre. Okay, so admettre. And this is the translation in English. Admettre. Then we'll have commettre. Commettre. Then émettre. Émettre. And you get a translation here. Permettre. Permettre. Promettre, promettre, remettre, remettre, soumettre, soumettre, transmettre, transmettre. And you get a translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in this video, we'll concentrate on the verb paraître. So this is the meaning of paraître, and the idea is that, of course, when we're talking about les préfixes, we will add few letters in front of paraître, and by adding these letters, we'll change the meaning of the verb. Okay, so let's see. The first one will be apparaître. Apparaître, and you've got here the translation in English. Disparaître, disparaître. Reparaître, reparaître. And you've got the translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes, okay? So, and in this video, we'll concentrate on the verb passer. And here you have the translation in English. Okay, so the idea is that we've got this verb passer, and then it will be possible to add some letters, so that's what we call préfix, in front of passer, and by adding these letters, well, we'll change the meaning, the original meaning of the verb passer. Okay, so let's see how it goes. So the first thing, if we add this dé, okay, we will get the verb dépasser, dépasser, and here you have the meaning in English. Okay, well, then we could add this re in front of passer, so we get this repasser, and then here is the meaning in English, repasser. Okay, and it's also possible to add sur, okay, surpasser, surpasser, and here is the meaning in English. Les préfixes et les verbes, okay, and in this video we'll focus on the verb porter, and that's how it could be translated. Okay, so the idea is that we will add some letters before, and then by adding these letters, the meaning, the original meaning of the verb will be modified. Okay, so let's see now. The first one, so if you add this AP, AP, you will get apporter, apporter. Okay, that's actually a translation of this verb, apporter. Okay, then we can add COM, so comporter, 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 okay, and that's the translation here. Or it could be se comporter, Okay, se comporter. And you have here the meaning of this verb. Then it's possible to add em, so you will get the en, emporter. Okay, emporter. And here is the translation. Ex, ex, exporter, exporter. Well, this one is actually quite easy to translate, okay? Exporter. Then it's possible to use this IM in front, so un, importer, importer. Okay, you can hear the translations. Then it's possible to use this RAP, so rap, rapporter, rapporter. And also, it's possible to use this REM, remporter. Okay? Remporter. Remporter. You can also add this SUP in front of porter. Sup. Supporter. Supporter. You don't really pronounce the two or the double P here. Supporter. And then it's possible to use this or to add this TRANS, trans, transporter, transporter, transporter. You can also use this RAP, rap, rapporter, rapporter. So same thing here, you don't pronounce the double P, rapporter. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in that video, we'll actually have poser. And so you've got the translations here. Okay, of poser. And so remember that, well, the idea is that we will add letters in front of poser, so that's what we call préfixe. And by adding these préfixes, we will modify the meaning or the original meaning of the verb poser. Okay, so let's see now what we've got. So it's possible to add this COM prefix, con, composer. Okay, composer. All right, and you've got here the translations of this verb. Composer. It's also possible to add the prefix D, accent aigu, D. D, and you get déposer, all right, déposer, and here you can find what it means in English, okay, déposer. It's also possible to add the prefix entre, 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 and you get entreposer, 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 okay, and here is the meaning. That it's possible to add this PRO, pro, proposer, okay, proposer. Or then you can also add this RE, re, reposer, 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 okay, and here you've got the translation. It's also possible to have, when we're talking about this reposer, well, this se reposer, se reposer, se reposer. Les préfixes et les verbes. And in this video, we'll actually focus on the verb prendre. Here is, or here are the translations possible for prendre, okay? And the idea is that, of course, we're talking about préfixe, so these letters that you can add before the verb, and by adding these letters, you will modify the original meaning of the verb. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. The first one, AP, so app, you will get apprendre, apprendre, okay? You don't pronounce the double P, apprendre, so here is what it means. Okay, apprendre. Then it's possible to put this com in front of prendre, and you will get comprendre, comprendre, okay, comprendre. It's also possible to use this entre, entre, entreprendre, entreprendre, entreprendre. It's also possible to use this re, re, reprendre, reprendre, reprendre. Okay, get translation here. S-U-R, sur, sur, surprendre. Okay, surprendre. And here is what it means. Okay, surprendre. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in this lesson, we'll concentrate on the verb tenir. And here is how you could translate this verb in English. Okay, so the idea is that it will be possible to add what we call prefix, so actually letters before this verb, and by adding these letters, you will modify the meaning, the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. So the first one that we have, if you add the letters C-O-N, con, you will get contenir, contenir, contenir. Okay, and that's how it could be translated. Then it's possible to add this E-N-T-R-E, entre, and you will get entretenir. Entretenir, entretenir. And here is the meaning. Okay, then it's also possible to add this M-A-I-N, main, maintenir, maintenir. Okay, and that's how you should, or you could translate it. It's also possible to use this R-E prefix, re, retenir. Retenir, and that's what it means. And also, S-O-U, sous, soutenir, soutenir, okay, soutenir. Les préfixes et les verbes, and the last verb that we will see together is venir, okay, so you get the translation here. Okay, so venir, and then when we talk about les préfixes, well, we will talk about letters that we will add in front of venir, and by adding these letters, we'll change the meaning or the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so let's see how it will go. The first thing that we could add would be con, con, and then we would get convenir. Convenir, okay, and here you will see for each verb the translation in English. Okay, convenir. We also have the possibility to add D and E, de, devenir. Okay, devenir. It's also possible to add this I-N-T-E-R, inter, inter, intervenir, intervenir. Intervenir. And then we can also add PRE accent aigu, pré, prévenir, prévenir, prévenir. Okay. We can add also this R. Re, revenir, revenir, revenir. And so it's possible to add this S-O-U, sous, okay, and the verb is réfléchir, se souvenir, se souvenir, se souvenir. It's also possible to add this S-U-B, sub, sub, Subvenir, subvenir, subvenir. And the last one, S-U-R, sur, survenir, survenir, survenir. Identical words in English and in French, and we'll concentrate on the words that ends with A-G-E in English. And the first thing that, well, we should definitely keep in mind is that they will be the same, but if they exist in French, because it's not the case all the time, okay? So we've got few exceptions. We will have few modifications possible in French, of course. And the thing that you should keep in mind, that in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that in this video, they will be masculine in French, okay? So that's one easy thing to remember. Of course, exceptions, but if you're not sure, then put the masculine form. In most of the cases, that will be the correct form, okay? So let's see them now. Un avantage. Un âge. Un arbitrage. Un assemblage. Un bagage. Un bandage. Un barrage. Un blocage. Un brassage. Un bricolage. Une cage. So this is one of the exceptions. It's feminine. Un camouflage. Un carnage. Un cartilage. Un chantage. Un collage. Un concubinage. Un cordage. Un corsage. Un courage. Un cousinage. Un découpage. Un dressage. Un entourage. Un équipage. Un espionnage. Un forage. Un fuselage. Un gage. Un garage. Un héritage. Une image. Keep in mind, feminine. Un langage. Un lavage. Un maquillage. Un mariage. Un massage. Un ménage. Un message. Une page. Feminine as well. Un passage. Un pelage. Une plage. Feminine. Une rage. Feminine as well. Un ravage. Un remariage. Un rivage. Un sabotage. Un usage. Un visage. Almost identical words in English and in French. And we're talking about the words that will end in English with IC, like that. And in French, that's the reason why they are almost identical. They will end with IQUE. Phonetically, it will be exactly the same. So IC. Ik, okay, but then we write it like that. Keep in mind that the first rule is that it must, of course, exist in French, and it's not all the time the case. And then in some cases, we will have few exceptions or modifications possible. Okay, so let's start. Académique. Acoustique. Acrobatique. Angélique. Aérodynamique. Aéronautique. Allergique. Analogique, anarchique, antinomique, athlétique, antiseptique, arctique, argotique, aristocratique, arithmétique, aromatique, artistique, asthmatique, astronomique, athlétique, atmosphérique, atomique, atypique, automatique, basique, bureaucratique, catholique, céramique, chaotique, caractéristique, charismatique, civique, classique, climatique, clinique, comique, cosmétique, cosmique, cubique, démagogique, démocratique, démographique, dermatologique, désertique, diabolique, diagnostique, diamétrique, didactique, dramatique, dramaturgique, dynamique, dynastique, écologique, économique, égocentrique, électrique, électronique, emblématique, empirique, encyclopédique, énigmatique, épidémique, épisodique, esthétique, éthique, ethnique, euphorique, évangélique, exotique, fabrique, fanatique, fantastique, fatidique, folklorique, frénétique, gastronomique, générique, génétique, géographique.
Almost identical words in English and in French, and we are talking about the words in English that will end with IC, like that, and in French, that's the reason why I said it was almost, because it's not totally identical, because we've got, in French, it will be with IQUE. Phonetically, it's the same. IC. IC. Okay, but we will write it like that. The first thing you should keep in mind is that, of course, the word must exist in French, and it's not the case all the time. And then, of course, we will have few exceptions or modifications possible. You will see that when I will read the words. Okay, so let's start now. Géologique, géométrique, gothique, graphique, gymnastique, héroïque, hiérarchique, historique, homéopathique, humoristique, hydraulique, hygiénique, hypnotique, idéologique, idiomatique, idyllique, illogique, inorganique, ironique, italique, journalistique, juridique, lactique, linguistique, lithographique, logique, logistique, lyrique, magique, magnétique, magnifique, maléfique, mathématique, mécanique, mélodique, méthodique, mimique, minéralogique, musique, narcotique, neurologique, nordique, nostalgique, numérique, océanique, Océanographique, oligarchique, ophtalmologique, optique, organique, orthopédique, panique, parodique, pédagogique, pédiatrique, philharmonique, philosophique, phonétique, photogénique, photographique, physique, plastique, platonique, poétique, polémique, politique, pragmatique, problématique, prolifique, psychiatrique, psychologique, public, pudique, république, romantique, rubrique, scientifique, sociologique, statistique, symbolique, tactique, technique, technologique, téléphonique, thermique, touristique, toxique, toxicologique, tragique, tropique, typique, véridique, vocalique, volcanique, volcanologique, zoologique, zygomatique.
Identical words in English and in French. Sorry, I was somewhere else. And we'll talk in this lesson about the words ending in English with a, de, e. Okay? And of course, the first thing that we've got to keep in mind is, well, the word must exist in French, which is not the case for all the words ending with ad. Okay? So that's the first thing. But then if they do exist, well, the meaning will be the same. Keep also in mind that we've got, of course, few exceptions or few modifications possible, and in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that they will be feminine. Okay, so we can start right now. Oops. Une accolade. Une arcade. Une balade. Une balustrade. Une barricade. Une brigade. Une cascade. Une charade. Une chiffonnade. Une escalade. Une escapade. Une esplanade. Une façade. Une fusillade. Une grenade. Une grillade. Une noyade. Une orangeade. Une palissade. Une parade. Une passade. Un plantigrade.
You've got an exception here.
Une promenade. Un or une rétrograde. Une sérénade. Un stade,
exception,
une tirade, une torsade.
Identical words in English and in French, and especially the words that will end with U, D, in English, well, actually, they will be written the same way in French, and the meaning will be the same, but the first rule that we've got to keep in mind is that, well, the word must exist in French, and it's not the case for all the U, D, words in English. Okay? And then the other thing, well, few exceptions, of course, or modifications possible. We're talking about accents or about modification of letters. Not that big, but still, they can occur. And then the second thing is that in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that they will be feminine. Okay? So let's see them now.
Une altitude. Une amplitude, une aptitude, une attitude, une béatitude, une certitude,
Une décrépitude. Une étude. Une exactitude. Une gratitude. Une habitude. Une inaptitude. Une incertitude. Une inexactitude. Une ingratitude. Une inquiétude. Un interlude. So, exception here. Une lassitude. Une latitude. Une longitude. Une multitude. Une platitude. Une plénitude. Un prélude. Second exception. Une promptitude. Une quiétude. Une rectitude. Rude. Une servitude. Une solitude.